Hey guys, it's Monica. I'm going to do a quick, hopefully, video. And the reason why it's gonna be quick is I'm only gonna address one thing. So I had posted on a couple of my social sites, you know, that tag that's going around, the assumption tag. So I thought it'd be kind of fun to do, and I did post that I would love to have some of your questions or assumptions about me and that I would address them. So one of the assumptions that I get often and that I have gotten recently on some of my older YouTube videos and also in direct messages on some of my social sites is about eyelid surgery. So I thought I would tackle that little thorny subject that doesn't seem to want to go away. So at the end of this video, I'm also going to do a giveaway. So I have three bottles of Blink. These are all unopened. So I've got like six here. So I'm going to do a giveaway, actually two giveaways, to someone who wants to try the eyelash serum to see how it will work for them. I do want to tell you that the expiration dates on this eyelash serum is July of 2019. So if you do win these, you should use them pretty quickly. Although anything that's unopened, as far as I'm concerned, for me, I don't mind using it. You know, I've used some of my vitamin C that's beyond an expiration date. I used some of my Retin-A that's beyond an expiration date, but I did want to tell you that. So if you're not interested, don't say you would like to try the Blink, because the rules are very, very clear. You have to be subscribed to the channel before this video went live. You have to thumbs up this video, and you have to leave in the comment, please, I'd like to try the Blink. You don't even have to use the word please, but I would like to try the Blink. Anyways, so three bottles will get you well through July without a doubt. I use this once a day, every single night. I do one dropper, I sanitize it, as said this before, and I put it on just like eyeliner with the little brush that comes with it on both eyes. And so three of these will get you through the amount of time that you need to definitely see a difference with this. So two lucky winners. So now let's tackle that question. Have I had eyelid surgery? Why do my eyes look so much better today than they have in the past if I didn't have surgery? I know you've had surgery. Anyone can tell by looking at you, Retin-A does not lift your eyelids the way you're claiming it has. Care Prost, that's what's lifted your eyelids? I don't think so. What else? Why don't you just admit that you went under the knife? So anyways, I'm being kind of fresh by the way I'm wording those questions, but I get those questions all the time. I'm not gonna sit here and claim to you that Retin-A has lifted my eyelids, or claim to you that Care Prost and Blink have contributed to lifting my eyelids. I'm going to tell you that for me, I know 100% that they have contributed, both of them together, to lifting my hoods. I have had hooded eyelids all my life. And you can see, I'm going to insert some photos in here. You can see some photos of me as a young child, as an adult, as, you know, growing up, etc. You can see all these photos, and over the course of time, in almost every single photo, I have hoods. Now, you can look at my eyes today and I still have hoods. I'm not sitting here saying to you that my hoods have completely disappeared. That's not the case. I still have hoods on my, I mean, I do. They still hang down. And I'm gonna show you a photo that was taken this morning when all I had on my face was mascara. So the first photo here is mascara only, because every photo I've ever taken, I've had mascara on. And then the second photo was a bit later on when I put a little bit more when I put some eyeshadow on. Now, I'm not an eyeshadow pro. I'm not a makeup expert. I do believe, however, that a good application of eyeshadow can make your hoods completely look different. You can look at some of the videos that Nisha from Sugar Puff and Fluff has done and others that have given tutorials on how to hide hooded eyes. I haven't mastered that yet, although I am trying really hard because I still have hoods. They haven't gone away. Have they gotten significantly better? In my opinion, yes. In my opinion, yes, I now have some landscape on my eyes between my lashes and, you know, the top part of my eyeball there. So you can actually see the lower movable lid that you could never see before because the hood would hang over that lower movable lid. So it never mattered whether I had eyeshadow on, you couldn't see it. Now you can see it. I don't have a ton of landscape there to play with, but I have some. I have more than I ever have had. Is it the Retin-A? Is it the Care Post or the Blink products? Gosh, I don't know. I suspect so, because that was really the only dramatic change. And yes, I did some derma rolling, but the first change has been from the Retin-A. So I've not had any kind of eyelid surgery. I wouldn't be against it, and I think for some, when it's medically needed, insurance will certainly pay for it. But if it isn't, it's treated like, in my opinion, would be more like cosmetic type surgery. And yeah, to me, that's not anything that I have on my radar to do. So is this a different, you know, is what you're seeing here on my eyelids because of my Retin-A use, because of the Bitum Riposte product that's in Careprost and Blink? There's been studies that say that that does help contribute to lifting. There's been studies that have said Retin-A. I'm gonna let you be the judge. The pictures will tell the story. I can honestly just tell you that from my perspective, when I apply my makeup, when I do mascara, when I do any kind of eyeshadow, it is a completely different process today than it was in 2016. Completely different. Now, these photos that you're going to see, these were taken mainly to monitor my eyelash journey. At that point in time, I never thought I'd be monitoring any kind of a hood lifting journey. And so these photos are not designed for that. They're just designed to show you the difference between my eyelashes when I first started to use an eyelash enhancing serum. And you can see how my eyelashes have grown dramatically. And I have been able to maintain that growth on my eyelashes, first from Careprost, then from a Blink, which is what I've been using this last year. Right now, in February into March, I'm giving all of that a rest, and I'm trying the City Lash for a month to see what happens, if there's any kind of fallout, if it's going to condition. I'm going to just see how my eyelashes react to that. But I just wanted to do this video to answer some of the questions that some of you have sent me. And it isn't even, I mean, the people that say this are names I don't even recognize. However, because it's asked, I thought, well, yeah, it'd be a great thing to talk about in a video. So is it hocus pocus? Is it makeup? That was one of the questions legitimately that one of you asked. Do you really think your eyes have lifted, or is it makeup? So I think this photo here in the morning you can see without the eyeshadow, and then right next to it with the eyeshadow. There is a difference with eyeshadow, and as I get better with applying it, there'll probably be more of a difference. But I don't think it's just makeup. I really don't. But I'm gonna let you be the judge. You make that decision when you take a look at these photos. So anyways, remember, if you want to try these, if you wanna see if your lashes will react like mine, I'm going to give two lucky subscribers 3 unopened little tubes of the Blink Eyelash Serum. This is continental US only. The shipping charges to go to, you know, Europe and overseas is just astronomical to ship this. It's a difficult process, so I do hope you understand. I always feel bad when I have a giveaway and it's open only to US only. But again, so these are 3 bottles each. You have to tell me you want to try the Blink in the comments below. I'm not going to respond to any comments. If you have any comments, if you have any further questions about eyes, or, you know, if you want to have more of a discussion on eyelid surgery, it'll be after I do this drawing. So I'm going to leave the drawing up. I'm not too sure. I think this might go public on Saturday. I'm gonna leave it up for a week, and then I will draw the name, and then I will announce the winner a week from Saturday. I'm not too sure what date that is. But that's the scoop, guys. So let me know if you want to give this a whirl. Thanks so much, and good luck. Bye, guys.